What is up, guys? I'm Daddy Gamer Fred, and welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're going to be talking about Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2, the remake for 2020, potentially coming to the Nintendo Switch, which to me, it's amazing. We're going to get into the leak in a second. If you're new around here, I do videos like this every day, talking leaks, talking Pokemon, having gameplay videos, let's plays, everything I kind of want on the channel. If you're enjoying the vibe, hit the subscribe button. I make sure I drop a video at least once a day. Also, hit the like button if you enjoy the video at any point. It does help out the channel and move the video into recommended so other people can check out the videos. Also, leave a comment in the comment section below. This is a discussion video. I want to hear from you guys. I answer all comments and respond to every one of you guys because this is a discussion. I want to hear from you guys. Do you want Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2 to come to the Nintendo Switch? Because right off the back, I do. I want this to actually lead to the game actually coming to the Nintendo Switch, because these images being data mined from the game's demo, while are a huge indicator that the game may be coming to the Nintendo Switch, that's still a maybe. The game could also get delayed, pushed back, even canceled. So I don't want to just put it out there that, hey, this confirms that the game is coming. This is a leak of a data mine from the game's demo. Now, on the leak, you see images of the Nintendo Switch and the Joy-Cons inside of the Nintendo Switch, and basically a button layout so you can configure the buttons and you can see what all the buttons do, as well as the same thing, the Joy-Cons inside of the Joy-Con grip. You know, that plastic dog controller looking thing that comes with the Nintendo Switch that no one actually uses. Well, that thing, you see the Joy-Cons in there, as well as another image, again, showcasing what the buttons do when you have the controller in there. Now, to me, this is very interesting because obviously, if it was a Steam controller, you know, build or something like that, this would be in the Steam files of the demo. However, that's not the case. Also, a lot of people are reporting that usually when there is a Steam controller layout, they use the Pro controller. And these aren't the Pro controller, especially with it inside of the Nintendo Switch. Kind of indicates, yeah, this is for the Switch, bro. Which is getting me very excited because me, I'm going to cop Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2. I want to play it day one, so I'm going to get it on the P4. I'm kind of itching to get it now so I can just play the demo. But I do want to wait. I do want to have that first reaction when the game drops. To me, that's, if I play the demo, I'm going to just be scratching at it. And I just want to just rip the Band-Aid off and dive fully into the game, rather than just, you know, have a taste now and then dive into it later. But this is like putting me on the fence. I'm like, Jesus Christ, do I wait for the Switch port? Because Jesus Christ, this would be a lovely game to have on the fucking Nintendo Switch, to be honest. I don't think we have a great skateboarding game on the Nintendo Switch, and this will make a great addition to the Nintendo Switch library, especially the Nintendo Switch feeling like a classic console already, where you go to and play all your remasters or your classic, you know, Crash Bandicoots on there. You got your old NES stuff. You know what I'm saying? It's a great mixed bag for me anyway. That's how I use my Switch, where I go to it for the retro stuff as well as go for, you know, games like Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy, Crash Team Racing, Spyro Trilogy. To me, those games fit well and best suited for the Switch because they're not like graphically intense games. While yes, you can get the PS4 versions and they look amazing, I think the portability factor just adds just tremendous amount of fun to the games and having it again portable. And I think that would do wonders for Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2. And that's why I'm just super excited that this is potentially a thing. And Activision always does stuff like this as far as like bringing games to the Nintendo Switch. We've seen it with the Crash Insane Trilogy. We've seen it with Spyro. Basically, when the game is coming out, usually on PS4 and Xbox One, PC, it will come out on those consoles, it will come out on the PC, and then make its way to the Nintendo Switch, because they do have to basically port the game over or get a different team to move the game over to the Nintendo Switch, squeeze it all down into a cartridge and stuff like that. And that is a whole different development cycle and usually takes more time to actually bring over to the Nintendo Switch. And usually Activision, right out the gate, when they, you know, are selling the game for PS4 and Xbox One, they will look into us in our face and be like, well, there's currently no plans. And then out of nowhere, a year later, be like, hey, look, there were plans. We lied. They did that with Crash. They did that with Spyro. They did that with, I believe, CTR as well. And I don't hate them for that. I think them making the decision of, you know, showing the game when the game is ready, having customers who are interested not wait and grab the game on PS4, boosts the sales on PS4. It's a smart marketing decision. They're not dumb. They're not going to tell you to wait. And I don't mind it. If the game is good, the game is good. It deserves to be bought. And if you want to play portable, you probably should buy it twice. I'm probably going to buy it twice. It's a head scratcher for me. But let me know in the comment section below your thoughts on Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2 potentially coming to the Nintendo Switch. Again, I'm making this video long. I'm trying not to. But again, it to me, it's just an amazing idea to just have these games on the portable console. Switch is probably one of my favorite consoles right now. And that's due to the fact that it's just everywhere. I could just throw it in a bag and take it to me at a restaurant. And, you know, while I'm chilling or whatever the case may be, I could just pull it out and play Mario Kart with my daughter. Like, how dope is that? And I don't know. That's why it has a special place in my heart. Let me know what you think in the comment section below about, again, Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2 coming to the Nintendo Switch. If you're new around here, I answer all comments. So I'm going to see you guys down there. And again, if you are new, hit that subscribe button. I do videos like this every day. Discussion videos, let's plays, pretty much anything I want. And I drop it here on the channel. If you into the vibes, again, hit that subscribe button. Also hit the like button. It does help me out a ton as far as moving the video and to recommend it so other people can check out the videos. Peace. I love you guys. I'm going to see you guys on the next one. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for making it to the end of this video. If you're not a subscriber and you made it this far, hit that subscribe button. You know you want to. Join the family. Ring the bell so you can be notified on the next time I drop one of my videos, as well as hit the like button on this video so it could be recommended so more people can check it out so we can have more people join in the family. If you want to keep up with me on other social media platforms such as Twitter, Instagram, or TikTok or whatever, I'm Daddy Gamer Fred on all of those. Again, Daddy Gamer Fred, you'll be able to find all those links in the description of this video and the pinned tweet comment on my Twitter. Also, on all of my videos, I do answer all comments. So again, if you just want to chat it up about the video or anything, just hit me up in the comment section below. I take time out of my day and literally answer to all the comments that you guys leave me, and I love it. And again, let's have that conversation down there. Here are a couple of suggested videos that you guys should check out that may be of your interest. I am a variety channel. I do tons of stuff, tons of Pokemon, but tons of other stuff as well. So dive into these videos. Peace. I love you guys. I'm gonna see you guys on the next one.